As the concerns about the growing bird flu outbreak intensify, there has been more testing of retail dairy products, and it shows no signs of the live virus. Here to talk why this is significant, Dr. Todd Ellerin of South Shore Health. Always like to have you here.
Good to be with you.
Yeah, it comes to consumer safety. The milk we drink, it matters, so this is big.
It really is. This is huge because the bottom line is the bird flu is in our milk supply, but the pasteurization, which is a fancy word for heating the milk, kills the virus. You can detect the virus, but it's these non-viable, not alive remnants, and it's not going to hurt us. But here's the but, Maria. We have to be careful for those who drink raw milk. You really right now want to stay away from raw milk products.
Okay, so at least 3 dozen herds of dairy cows, they have been found to be infected. And we're learning that the virus may have gone undetected for months. That's concerning, for sure. Why wasn't this caught sooner? Is that a concern?
All right, so again, we know with the pandemic, December 2019, we know that COVID was circulating for months before.
All right.
The USDA, Department of Agriculture, they're responsible for food safety and also the commercialization of the product. So there's a little problem there. So what they need to do is really be aggressive, which they are now, about testing, making sure the farmers are testing the milk products, not just with the sick animals, but also with the animals that are healthy, so we know how widespread this is.
But it's not just the cows that they're watching with this outbreak, and that's the concern. There are actually other livestock that could be more concerning. This is a rolling ball, or is it not?
I'm glad you said that, because pigs, for example, that we haven't heard about, pigs can be a mixing vessel where they can be infected with human influenza as well as avian, the bird flu. And if that's an issue, because when they can recombine, then you're more likely to get infected with humans. But the one thing I want to say is so far we've only seen 2 humans infected with bird flu in the United States.
That's too many, though.
It's too many. We know it hasn't adapted yet, but we want to get ahead of this to make sure it doesn't adapt to humans.
That's always the key. Yeah. Dr. Todd Ellerin, be well.
Thank
you, doctor. We appreciate that.